Meet the Bobcat 5600D. And what is it doing, you may be asking? Well, only preventing massive catastrophic crashes and maintaining the function of our airport runways. Well now, that sounds interesting. What is it specifically doing? It's scraping up rubber off the road. Yep, rubber. But just how much rubber builds up on a runway anyway? And why is it so important to keep an eye out for it? Well, take a look at a typical plane like this Airbus A380. It has 22 tires. These tires are stationary when the plane comes to land, but when they hit the ground, they instantly speed up to 170 miles per hour. As you might expect, the friction in this process means the tires get very hot. What are these tires made of? Well, rubber, of course, and rubber melts. The end result? Each tire on the plane leaves 1.5 pounds of rubber on the runway for every landing. Multiply this by the A380's 22 tires and you get 33 pounds. And of course, that A380 isn't the only plane that'll be landing. At a busy airport like New York's JFK, you can expect over 13,000 pounds of rubber accumulated on just one runway every day. Why is this so dangerous? Because this rubber junk makes the runway smoother, reducing the friction with the ground that the airplane needs to slow down and stop. Also, rubber can build up on the landing lights that guide planes when they touch down. Without these signals, planes would leave the boundaries of the runway, which is just asking for deadly accidents to happen. The rubber problem gets worse when the weather isn't good. A master sergeant with the U.S. Air Force explained in an interview just how dangerous rain mixed with rubber junk can be. When it gets into the rainy season, the rain will get on the runway. So what that could do is cause hydroplaning, and the aircraft could slide off the runway into the infield, and it could damage or cause a loss of the aircraft or loss of life. So removing the rubber buildup is a top priority for airports. Fortunately, they have specialized equipment to do it, ranging from really high-pressure water jets to sometimes nasty chemicals. The first problem that maintenance crews need to solve is that the rubber sticks to the surface really tightly. If you've ever tried to unstick two papers folded together by glue, you get a fraction of the idea. But it's even tougher than that. Airport maintenance crews need a lot of force to get the rubber off the road. How much? Well, one preferred way of scraping the rubber off is by using spinning water jets that have a pressure of 2,500 to 3,000 bar, or about 36,260 to 43,500 psi. For comparison, your typical fire hose sprays with pressures of 100 to 300 psi. With these water jets, the maintenance crews can break the rubber apart without damaging the concrete beneath it. The jets can come from multiple machines, too, ranging from hand-push devices that look a little like a lawnmower to large trucks. But although this method is effective and environmentally friendly, since the waste can be quickly disposed of, it's slow. Even a truck can only clean one little part of the runway at a time. Although cleaning sessions usually happen at night when there's less traffic, busy airports like JFK are always buzzing. So there are other, faster methods that can get rid of the rubber. Chemical cleaning is one of them. Trucks drive up and down the runway and spray specialized chemicals. For a concrete runway, the chemicals usually include a acrylic acid base mixed with a benzene and a synthetic detergent that acts as a wetting agent. For asphalt runways, alkaline-based mixtures are used. These chemicals break apart and dissolve the rubber deposits. Afterward, the mixture is cleaned away with water. But there are drawbacks to using these chemicals. Airport services manuals warn workers to exercise extreme care when handling them. If they stay too long on the runway, they'll harm the concrete or asphalt. And that's just asking for much more expensive and time-consuming maintenance. The chemicals are also far from environmentally friendly. Training documents stress that workers must dilute them a lot to ensure they won't harm any plants or wildlife, and to take special care to keep them away from drainage systems. With all these drawbacks, it helps to have another method. And there is one. A truck with large mechanical scrubbers installed in the front. It looks a little like a steamroller. As the vehicle moves forward, these scrubbers rotate at high speed and lift the rubber from the runway. At the end of a cleaning session through whatever method, the crew will drive up and down the runway to check in on the lights. Then they'll use another high-pressure hose or dry ice blasting to get rid of leftover rubber. What happens to the waste rubber and cleaning materials? The team will collect them with special vacuums or recovery trucks. Whatever rubber can be recycled will be. The remainder will be disposed of and sent to a landfill. Meanwhile, the wastewater and chemicals will go to treatment plants. Once the water has been purified, it will either be released into a body of water or be reused. This process will be done at an airport like JFK 3 to 5 times per week, and each session can take up to 4 hours. Some airports require even more maintenance. Rubber builds up faster in tropical locales because of the greater heat. It might all sound like a pain, and it is, but now you see why runways need to be cleaned frequently. This elaborate process raises another question, though. If they get so hot on impact, why don't these tires just melt away completely or even explode? As it turns out, there's some insane engineering behind airplane tires. All this time, we've talked about rubber, and that's not entirely accurate. Airplane tires are composite materials. There's rubber in them, yes, but also synthetic rubber compounds, nylon, aramid fabrics, and even Kevlar. The tires are also filled with nitrogen gas, unlike regular air. Why? Because oxygen burns, obviously. Nitrogen doesn't. It also doesn't expand or contract as much as typical air when the temperature changes, so the tires stay at a consistent pressure. But to see how clever these tires really are, it helps to look beyond the materials that make them. Look at the product design. They're a lot different than car tires. Aircraft tires have circumferential vertical grooves. They're designed that way to ensure a safe landing on rainy days. The grooves get rid of the water between the tire and the pavement by safely channeling it away. The end result is that the tires can grip the runway exactly as they could during more pleasant conditions. As you might have guessed by now, these tires are designed to survive stressful conditions. Some of them can withstand over 200 psi of air pressure, 6 times that of a car tire. And you might be thinking by now, okay, so the tires are well designed, but if they're shedding rubber like crazy, they must not have a long service life, so they're kind of a failure. And that expense is probably showing up on my airfare. Well, maybe not, because it turns out the engineers accounted for this too. Each tire can land 500 times before it needs to be retreaded. Also, each tire can be retreaded 7 times before it finally needs to be sent into retirement. So yeah, these little devices that you likely haven't thought a lot about until now are pretty amazing. In many ways, they make modern life possible. But there's one thing they can't do. They can't provide a secret sauce for landing in winter conditions. Airport crews will need to do the grunt work of keeping runways clear, even during a blizzard. So, how do maintenance teams battle old man winter? Snowplows are the first line of defense. These machines are coordinated almost like an armored formation, and much like their military counterparts, they're constantly drilled. Snow removal training is routinely practiced to ensure that when the time comes, the maintenance crew can work efficiently. And the training pays off, because these guys can clean snow off of long runways in minutes, which is more than enough time for incoming planes to land safely. But winter just doesn't bring snow. Black ice on roads is a lot more dangerous, and when it comes to runway safety, an ounce of prevention is worth much more than a pound of cure. That's why the crews use de-icing chemicals. They're made of substances like potassium acetate. Sometimes glycol-based solutions are preferred. These compounds not only melt ice, they prevent it from forming on the runways even in sub-zero temperatures. Without the right training and materials, a lot of flights would be canceled. There'd also be a lot more deadly accidents on the runways. Thanks to well-trained crews and good equipment, airports make sure that things stay safe year-round. But that raises a final question. Winter conditions are obvious. How does the airport know that it's time to clean a runway when it's nice and sunny outside? You know by now that if they don't respond promptly to junk buildup on the runway, bad things can happen. Fortunately, there's a specialized machine for that too. This one is called the RT3 Friction Tester. This device measures how slippery a runway is and gives real-time data since it's attached to a car driving over the pavement. The data is fed to a computer inside the vehicle, letting the driver know exactly what parts of the runway are good and what parts need to be worked on. Safety is measured on a scale of 1 to 18. A measurement of 8 or higher is required for safe landings. If the scale goes below 8, it means the friction is not high enough for a landing aircraft to get a good grip on the pavement. Maintenance crews will need to clear that part of the runway immediately. Fortunately, the software is easy to read. It's even color-coded to let operators know the situation instantly. You've probably never seen the RT3 before, but without it, there's no way your last plane ride would have been safe. If not for the accurate friction testing it provides, planes would slide off the runway, especially in bad weather. But thanks to the RT3 and all the other well-designed components that make landing safe, you can jet around the world on your merry business, confident you're not gonna have a crash landing. Bye for now.